Welcome to the session of design paradigm. Design paradigm belongs to the activity of design thinking, which belongs to the second phase of UX life cycle. The term paradigm means an example or pattern. Design paradigms can be used either to describe a solution or as an approach to design problem solving. So there are three design paradigms which we are going to consider for designing. First, engineering paradigm. Second, human information processing paradigm, and third, design thinking paradigm. Let us consider one by one. The first paradigm is engineering paradigm, where we consider the engineering parameters of design, where we focus on the user performance, reliability, functionality, and vision for the new system, etc. We need to evaluate the model and find errors, if any, and then iterate the model to provide good user productivity while using the product. The second design paradigm is human information processing paradigm, where we consider how does the system understands the input of the user and how information is processed and transformed in human mind. This paradigm helps in making the system a long-term memory in user's mind. The third design paradigm is design thinking paradigm, where we consider emotional aspects of the user. For example, the joy of using the system or immersion. This paradigm helps to reframe the interaction design practice to bring out the best user experience while using the product. These paradigms are just frameworks within which to think about design. The paradigms are not necessarily mutually exclusive. They do overlap and can be complementary. In most real system or product development, there is a room for more than one approach. There is a need for creativity and innovation in all the three paradigms. For better understanding, let us consider the example of a car design in terms of three design perspective. When we consider engineering view of the car, we need to consider the performance and features of the car. The other factors which we can consider is thickness of steering wheel, seat height, adjustment, curve of the seats, etc. When we say about human information processing, we will consider about the information the system gives us about the problems in the car. For example, low tire pressure, bonnet open, etc. While considering the design paradigm, we need to consider the emotional aspects of the user, like the joy of driving, pride of ownership, etc. Thank you.